Act 7. Brooder pneumonia. This disease is caused by pelt, mold, or fungus. Usually affects young chickens. Signs: convulsions, sleepiness, loss of appetite, coughing and gasping for air, sometimes paralysis as a result of nervous system infection. Treatment: strict sanitation, clean and disinfect incubators, brooders, feeders, and waterers with Clorox or appropriate disinfectant. Remove all litters and change brooder paper every day to prevent a build up of droppings. Once infected, use 1/2 teaspoon of copper sulfate to 1 gallon of water for 5 to 7 days. Bronchitis. Infectious bronchitis is a serious respiratory disease similar to CRD. It spreads rapidly and usually affects baby chicks. Signs: a rattle in the throat when you hold the chick next to your ear, sneezing and nasal discharge or swollen face are symptoms of bronchitis. On older chickens, the waddles will swell up with fluid and sneeze and cough. Also rattle in the upper respiratory tract. Treatment: vaccinate with Newcastle bronchitis vaccine in water. In this method is used, vaccinate every 2 to 4 months as long as you have chickens. Infected birds should be isolated to prevent rapid spreading of this disease. Treat with Thailand 50, 1 cc under the skin of the neck, and 1 cc in the breast every day for 3 days. Skip 3 days and repeat. Betrex 5 drops in the mouth and 5 drops in the ear, in each nostril, will help relieve the bronchial infection. A combination of 1 part B12 1000, 1 part Thailand 50, and 1 part penicillin procaine, coach 3-in-1, is a very good antibiotic. Give 1 cc every day for 3 days, skip 3 days, and repeat if necessary. Ganun po pag-injection ng antibiotic. Medication: most disease of the respiratory system can be treated with the following medication. Thailand 50. Based on the size of the infected chicken, give 1/2 cc intramuscular in breast, being sure to penetrate the muscle 1/2 to 3/4 inches deep using a 3/4 inch 21 gauge needle. 1 cc should be used for chicken over 4 pounds. Medication given in the muscle usually takes about 3 to 4 hours before becoming effective and will usually last 24 to 36 hours. Use 1/2 to 1 cc of Thailand 50 based on the size of the chicken under the skin of the neck, which is called subcutaneous. This method of injection allows the medication to slowly enter the body and provide long-lasting relief. Thailand 50 is also effective for sinus infection as indicated by swollen face with watery or bubbly eyes using a syringe. Draw 1/4 cc of Thailand 50, remove the needle and wash the eyes out with a few drops in each eye. This method is called interocular and is very effective in treating the sinus cavity of your gamecocks. Betrex is an old remedy but is very effective for all respiratory problem. Apply 2 drops in each nostril, 5 drops in the mouth, and apply to the entire head and under the wings will help the cock breathe much easier. Gallimycin, poultry formula. Mix 1 teaspoon to 1 gallon of water and use as sole source of drinking water for 7 to 10 days. Gallimycin injectable. If after 7 to 10 days your cock will has a cold, inject 1/2 cc to 1 cc bread on size. Embrace every 3 days for 3 treatments. 3-in-1. Since Combiotic is no longer available, I have found that using a mixture of 10 cc of B12 with 10 cc of Thailand 50 and 5 cc of penicillin procaine in 1 bottle and storing in a refrigerator is very effective when administered 1/2 cc to 1 cc IM or subcutaneous SC for almost any viral infection. Electrolyte. Add to wet feed using 1 ounce of electrolyte to 1 gallon of water and soaking the feed for 24 hours will ensure the cock will not dehydrate. Most chicken that have a cold do not drink very much water. Do not try to force them to drink by squirting water down their throats, as they will usually cause the fluid to end up in his air sacs or lungs, causing death. By adding the electrolytes and vitamins to the wet feed will prove effective in rehydrating your cock. Vitamins. A good blood builder such as Bisorbin is expensive but will help maintain a high energy level. Most respiratory disease can be prevented by keeping the areas clean, feeding a good balanced diet, fresh clean water daily, and eliminating any stagnant water. If you use the old method of killing sick chickens to prevent disease, you will soon be out of gamecocks. Okay, anatomy and physiology of the digestive system. The digestive system consists of 7 parts and is illustrated in photo number 8. Yan po siya. Number 1, beak or oropharynx, esophagus or throat, stomach and gizzard, small intestines, large intestines, 6, liver, 7, pancreas. Those are 7. Okay. The following is a discussion about each of these and how they work. The beak or oropharynx is where the cock first pick up feed. The beak has ridges, salivary glands, and tongue. The ridges are located in the top of the beak and a small fiber-like membranes to help move the feed to the throat. While being moved by the ridges, the salivary glands secrete a watery like substance to help moisten the feed. The tongue helps force the feed to the throat. The finger-like attachment helps the feed out of the beak to the opening of the throat. Number 2. The esophagus or throat is simply a passageway from the beak to the crop no digestion occurs in the crop. The crop is a storage sack for feed until the cock stomach is empty. Okay. Part 8.